What's up, YouTube? Welcome back to another episode of the 1% Better Podcast. I'm your host, Matthew Mazza, and I come on here every Wednesday and every Sunday to bring you guys some motivation by reading from John Maxwell's The Daily Reader. All right, so let's go ahead and jump into today's read. June 25th, defining the team. We've all seen teams that have a common goal yet lack common values. Everyone on the team has different ideas about what's important. The result is chaos. Eventually, the team breaks down if everyone tries to do things his own way. That's why team members need to be on the same page. Just as personal values influence and guide an individual's behavior, organizational values influence and guide the team's behavior. If you want to add value to your team and help it reach its potential, then you need to share it in its values. First, make sure you know what they are. Then, examine your values and goals in comparison to them. If you can wholeheartedly buy into the team's values, commit yourself to aligning yourself with them. If you can't, then your misalignment will be a constant source of frustration to you and your teammates, and you might want to think about finding a different team. The 17 Indisputable Laws of Teamwork. Are you and your teammates on the same page when it comes to values? So the first thing I think about is like any type of business, team I've been on in sports, and how successful that team was, right? And the first thing that like in football, all they always talk about is like we're one fine-tuned engine, right? And everybody has their own individual roles and things of that nature, but we all have to work in unison for the engine to run correctly, right? And it's no different than like what I am doing right now in the car business. Like we all have to share the same value, right? We want to sell 300 plus cars every single month at my dealership. And the way we do that is by creating a vision and a mission statement with our team so that way everybody can share the same values and hop on board and makes it more of a seamless transaction. But when everybody's working immediately against each other, right? Constant source of frustration, right? Nobody's sharing the same values. Nobody's on the same page. And when you're doing that, it's almost impossible not to hit the wall and have everything kind of fall apart, right? And the first thing you got to do is understand, like, is everybody on the same page? Do we all share the same values? Because if you don't, like he talks about, you might want to look for a different team, right? At my dealership, a lot of us share these same values, right? Now, obviously, you're going to have one or two people, maybe they're new or maybe they just don't have the right mindset that might not be, you know, on the same page or right mindset like we all have. But 98% of us are on the same page. We want the same things. We want to create a lifestyle and an environment for our team to have a successful life and a successful career, right? Every single month, we're all striving to sell 300 cars a day, doing what we can and helping each other out in our individual roles and working together at the same time to hit that goal every single month, right? But you have to understand what your values are, right? Can you commit to them and fully align yourself with them, right? If the values in your workplace aren't what you share or aren't what you think about personally or you don't value them the same way personally, then you need to be on a different team. You need to find people that value the same things you do, right? Because you want to be around like-minded people, right? I only want to be around those who are succeeding at high levels, right? So if I'm on a team of, you know, mediocre people who just want to be lax and everything like that, it makes me a little uncomfortable because I'm constantly trying to push the envelope and constantly trying to get better and do things differently so that way I can get a different result instead of trying to do the same thing and getting a different result every single time, which is the form of which is the true definition of insanity, right? Doing the same thing every single time the exact same way and expecting a different result is the fucking truest definition of insanity, right? If things aren't working, we gotta change them, right? If the team's not the team you're supposed to be on, fucking change it. Get on the team that is your, that works well with your values and ideas, right? So that way you can align yourself with that team a lot easier, make it seamless, right? Because even though like what I'm saying sounds very individual, think about it for the team. If you're a puzzle piece trying to fit in a puzzle, but you're the wrong puzzle piece, you'll never complete that puzzle. So think about how that team feels. They feel the exact same way you do. They feel like you're the odd man out. You're the black sheep in the room, right? You're the person that doesn't fit the mold. So they want you gone just as much as you want to be gone because they understand it doesn't create a copious environment for everybody to succeed because you don't share the same values. So that's how important this stuff really is, okay? So next time you're in any type of situation where you feel like, you know, you're hitting a wall with your team and you're not hitting your goals, evaluate what your values are and understand, is everybody on that team sharing the same values? Because if you're the captain, the leader of the team, but you got some weak links and it's due to the fact of they don't share the same values, it has nothing to do with their training, anything like that. But because they don't share the same values as you, that is a clear-cut reason why you need to let that person go and try to find another team where they can truly succeed. Because not only are you going to benefit your life and your team success, you're going to benefit that person's life, right? There's no reason to keep people lingering around when they don't fit the mold, right? The best thing you could do is fucking rip the Band-Aid off immediately so that person can go find the right team for them and that person can go fucking succeed. Because we don't want to stop somebody else from succeeding, even though it might hurt us in the beginning. But in the long term, right, it's not only going to benefit you and your team, it will benefit that person as well, to give them that chance to go ahead and find the team that will help them succeed because they share the same values, right? But that also gives you the space and opportunity to bring somebody else in on your team to allow you to succeed every time, right? Because now you understand we can't have another person like that, and the only way you're going to fail is by hiring the same exact person. So you have to take a mental note of like, hey, this person didn't work out and why. So that way when you interview the next fucking person, you understand what that person needs to be like to fit the mold and criteria of your team, right? If you want to be an A player, right, and have a super successful team, you got to hire other A players, right? And this is another thing, right? Most A players are scared to hire somebody that's better than them because they think they're going to lose their job. This is a little bit off topic, but it's true, right? If you want to have a super successful team, you need to have people that share the same values of wanting to be fucking A players and not fear that because they might be better than you, that it's going to take away from your success, right? It's only going to make you more successful and give you more freedom, right? Because if you have everybody who is fucking on the same mission as you to get better every single day and they want to be the best A player that they could be for the team, you can start delegating the work that you don't want to do to somebody who's going to take it over and trust that they will do it to the best of their abilities because they share the values of, and the mission and the vision of what your team wants to accomplish, no matter if it's in business, life, whatever it is, right? That person is going to take the responsibilities that you're delegating to them and take it and run to the fucking hills with it and do their best to make sure that they do it right by you and your team because they share the same values. They want the same thing. They're after the same goals. And that's pretty much it. But this can correlate into anything, right? If you have a significant other who doesn't share the same values as you and you're in a constant fucking battle between each other, that's because you're with the wrong fucking person. And you need to let that person go to go meet somebody with the same values and allow yourself to do the exact same thing. Because if that person doesn't support your goals and your mission and you compromise just because you want to make them happy for the relationship to survive, brother or sister, you are fucking up royally. Let that motherfucker go and let him go immediately before you fuck their life up and you fuck your life up. It's not fucking worth it. We have to take time to ourselves and understand, are we aligning with the team correctly? Are we on the right team, right? Because this is why relationships fail all the time. Because you don't look for the same fucking things that you should be looking in a partner to make you guys successful, right? You need to express that you share the same values and goals and have the same mindset and vision in place for the family you want to create. It's like I said, they correlate in business, they correlate in personal relationships. You can think about this in any situation you want, right? If you guys are in a group and you don't share the same values, you don't share the same mission, and you don't share the same vision, you will only go so far. You will constantly hit a wall. So really think about it and challenge yourself. The next time you hit a wall with your team, look to make sure everybody shares the same values, that they all align with the vision and mission of the team. And when you find the missing link that stands out because they don't share the same values, let that person go. Let them be free of the team so they can go find the right team for them and succeed, and you can allow yourself to grow the team properly, to have everybody on the same page, and you can stop hitting the wall, and you can move into a seamless transition and constantly hit your goals and get better and be consistent, right? So I appreciate it, guys. That's all I got for you today. I will see you on Wednesday, and we'll continue this train fucking going. I'm loving every minute of it, and we're going to finish up day 55 of 75 hard. So 20 fucking days left. I feel great. I actually hit an all-new low in weight right now. I'm at 201 pounds, so super happy with myself and the growth, but it's just constantly thinking about ways that I can get better. So I always want to strive to be 1% better, and I hope you guys too. I hope you guys find so much value in these videos. That's all I ask for. I don't ask for anything else. You know, if you would, like, subscribe, and comment, whatever you want to do, and just continue to follow. If you get anything from these videos, share it with somebody else, right? Because somebody else might need to listen to this message, because they may be going through something that correlates with this message. And if I can help somebody get better, 1% better in any type of fucking way, I'm doing my job. But I appreciate it. I'll see you guys on Wednesday. I'm going to wrap up my day of 75 hard, and we'll see you next time.